January 20, 2009, Barack Obama takes office as President of the United States, succeeding George Bush. Far from the cameras, they meet privately to discuss sensitive topics. President Bush entrusts his successor with the continuation of two secret programs. One is conventional and relates to drone strikes in Pakistan. The other seems to come straight out of a sci-fi novel. Yet, it is about to completely shake modern warfare. Its codename, Olympic Games. Rewind 3 years prior. The U.S. government suspects the Islamic Republic of Iran of developing a military nuclear program passing as civilian nuclear power activity. Should Iran possess the atomic bomb, the cards in the region would be reshuffled, threatening Israel's strategic position in the Middle East. George Bush is in a deadlock. He has lost the credibility to take the country into another war following the debacle in Iraq, but he will not allow Iran to possess nuclear capabilities. He calls for a third option. One of his generals proposes the development of a malware targeting Iran's nuclear infrastructure with the aim of slowing down the program. The Olympic Games Project was born. Stuxnet is presumably the result of the joint development of the NSA and Unit 8200 of the Israeli Army. The goal is to destroy the centrifuges of the Natanz nuclear plant. As the site is completely cut off from the internet, the virus is first inserted in the plant's suppliers and service providers. It's just a matter of time before one of them plugs inside the facility a USB key contaminated by the virus. Once in the plant's network, Stuxnet expands and takes root by exploiting secret vulnerabilities called Zero Day in the operating system. Fully autonomous, it discreetly sets up its own server to constantly receive updates. As a stealthy threat, it progresses gradually through all layers of the site, forcing the final walls with digital certificates stolen from major computer companies. The virus continues to move into the industrial network and seeks its final target, the centrifuge's electronic control system. By taking control, Stuxnet disables emergency security measures, exploiting a lack of in-depth defense measures. Soon, an unbearable noise resonates in the plant. The centrifuges become unmanageable, and their speeds accelerate uncontrollably. Ultimately, more than 1,000 centrifuges explode. This spectacular attack should not make us lose sight of the fact that the vectors of infection have been simple, removable data storage media, so common inside companies. As long as their use is not part of a holistic approach to cybersecurity, organizations will continue to suffer considerable damage to their information systems. Stuxnet was the first virus to hit industrial infrastructures and paved the way for a new generation of cyber attacks that can impact the physical world. 10 years ago, Stuxnet opened Pandora's box. Cube Cleaner offers a sanitization station to analyze and decontaminate removable USB media. The Cube analyzes the media and informs the user of its state. In case of forgetfulness or malice, the USB key is rejected if it has not been previously decontaminated. Cube Cleaner also has network features that enable seamless and secure data sharing within an organization.